Now, in this lecture, we will have the discussion on the demodulation process of the SSB-SC modulated signal. If we take a quick look at the block diagram of the communication system, then in the transmitter section, we have used SSB-SC modulation technique and modulated the message signal by shifting its maximum frequency FM to a higher or lower frequency by using the carrier frequency plus minus FC. After performing the modulation, the signal is transmitted from the transmitter to the receiver through the channel. The receiver receives the modulated signal, and this modulated signal needs to be demodulated to get actual information on the message signal. So at the receiver end, message signal is recovered from the SSB-SC modulated signal. The process of extracting this original message signal from the SSB-SC modulated signal is known as the detection or the demodulation of the SSB-SC modulated signal. Basically, coherent or synchronous detector is mainly used for the demodulation of the SSB-SC modulated signal. This technique of retrieving the original message signal from an SSB-SC modulated signal is called SSB-SC detection or demodulation, and this is achieved through the use of coherent detector, which is also known as synchronous detector. This detection is one of the most simple detection techniques, where the detection of the SSB-SC modulated signal is done with the help of product modulator and a low pass filter. The carrier signal used here is the same carrier signal that is used in the generation of the SSB-SC modulated signal. Let's see the block diagram for the coherent detection of the SSB-SC modulated signal. At first, SSB-SC modulated signal ST is given as the input to the product modulator. Another input to the product modulator is the carrier signal CT or cos omega CT generated by the local oscillator. Output of the product modulator or YT is the product of two inputs, or YT is equal to ST into CT. This output is passed through a low pass filter having the cutoff frequency of plus minus W. The output of this low pass filter is Y0T, which is our desired demodulated message signal. Let's see the mathematical analysis for this coherent detection of the SSB-SC modulated signal. This mathematical analysis can be done in three processes. At first, we will consider that the carrier signal from the local oscillator has a phase shift of 0 degree and an amplitude of 1. Next, we will consider the case when the carrier signal has a phase shift of phi and an amplitude of 1. And finally, we will consider the case where the local oscillator has a frequency shift of del f and an amplitude of 1. In this lecture, we will only discuss the main coherent detection of the SSB-SC modulated signal with a phase shift of 0 degree and an amplitude of 1. Let's say SSB-SC modulated signal can be given by ST is equal to AC by 2 into MT into cos omega CT plus minus M cap of T into sin omega CT, where M cap of T is the Hilbert transform of the message signal MT. And the carrier signal generated by the local oscillator or CT is equal to cos omega CT. So the output of the product modulator YT is the multiplication of this two signal, or YT is equal to ST into CT. If we place the value of ST as AC by 2 into MT into cos omega CT plus minus M cap of T into sin omega CT and CT as cos omega CT, then the equation of the YT will become YT is equal to AC by 2 into MT into cos omega CT plus minus M cap of T into sin omega CT into cos omega CT. We can multiply this cos omega CT with both the terms, then YT can be written as YT is equal to AC by 2 into MT into cos square omega CT plus minus AC by 2 into M cap of T into sin omega CT into cos omega CT. Now, we will divide and multiply both of the terms of YT by 2, then YT can be written as AC by 4 into 2 into MT into cos square omega CT plus minus AC by 4 into 2 into M cap of T into sin omega CT into cos omega CT. Now, by rearranging the two, this equation can be written as this, and this 2 cos square omega CT can be written as 1 plus cos 2 omega CT, and this 2 sin omega CT into cos omega CT can be written as sin 2 omega CT. Then equation of YT can be written as YT is equal to AC by 4 into MT into 1 plus cos 2 omega CT plus minus AC by 4 into M cap of T into sin 2 omega CT. Now we need to multiply this AC by 4 into MT with both the terms, then the equation of YT can be written as YT is equal to AC by 4 into MT plus AC by 4 into MT into cos 2 omega CT plus minus AC by 4 into M cap of T into 2 omega CT. This output YT is passed through a low pass filter, which does not allow the high frequency term or attenuates them and only allows the low frequency term to pass through. Here AC by 4 into MT is the message signal multiplied by a constant of AC by 4. It has the frequency equal to FM. AC by 4 into MT into cos 2 omega CT is the message signal multiplied by a constant of AC by 4 and a high frequency term cos 2 omega CT. It has the frequency 2FC plus minus FM. And AC by 4 into M cap of T into sin 2 omega CT is the Hilbert transform message signal multiplied by a constant of AC by 4 and a high frequency term sine 2 omega ct. It has the frequency 2 fc plus minus fm. The two high frequency term are ac by 4 into mt into cos 2 omega ct and ac by 4 into m cap of t into sine 2 omega ct will be eliminated due to the low pass filterization. So the output of the low pass filter or y naught t is equal to message signal mt multiplied by a constant of ac by 4. So we have managed to generate message signal from the SSB-SC modulated signal with the help of coherent detection. So there are few drawbacks of this detection process, and they are: the modulator circuit is very complex. For the synchronization of the two carriers, the cost of the circuit increases, and phase and the frequency error could be generated due to improper synchronization. Now let's see the graphical analysis for this SSB-SC demodulation. Upper sideband SSB-SC modulated signal is ST, and the carrier signal CT is equal to cos 2 pi FCT, and the output signal from the product modulator or YT is equal to ST into CT. The Fourier transform of the upper sideband SSB-SC modulated signal is equal to capital S of F, and the Fourier transform of the carrier signal CT, which is equal to capital C of F, which is equal to half into del F minus FC plus del F plus FC. As the output signal from the product modulator or YT is equal to SSB-SC modulated signal ST multiplied by carrier signal CT, then the result in the frequency domain is the convolution of these two signal, or Y of F is equal to capital S of F convoluted with capital C of F. Now we can replace the C of F by the Fourier transform of the carrier signal. Now after performing the convolution, this will result in the modulated signal frequency shift to the carrier frequency FC. Now this is the frequency domain representation for the upper sideband SSB-SC modulated signal, and this is the frequency domain representation for the output of the product modulator. When this is passed through a low pass filter having the frequency plus minus FC, it will only allow this message signal to pass through. Hence, the demodulation of this SSB-SC modulated signal is performed. This concludes our discussion for this lecture. In the event that you have any question regarding this presentation, feel free to post them in the comment section, and don't forget to hit the subscribe button. See you in the next one.